what's up, you guys? It's Dustin, and I'm back. And I just want to say off the top, this is not going to be a highly edited video. I'm just going to directly upload this. This is also not going to be a typical video that you would receive from me or see or whatever. This video is about net neutrality. I can't even say the fucking word. But if you don't know what this is going to be a crash course in what you need to know about it and why it's going to impact you and many, many others that you know. Everyone that you know will be affected by this in some way. Okay, so today, if you don't know, it was a big thing because 5 people were going to vote on net neutrality. And net neutrality is basically this thing where it's in place, like right now, if you pay for internet service, you are supposed to get the speed that you pay for. I have 100 by 10. That is the maximum that my carrier has. Well, no, there's a higher speed, but if I go to any website, I'm supposed to get that speed. Without this, without net neutrality, if you pay for the fastest internet speed, you may get a list of websites that you can access at full speed. So, let's say for instance, if you want to get on Facebook and message your mom, you know, messaging, it's not something that takes a lot of data unless you send pictures and things like that. But if Facebook is not in your plan with your provider, you may end up paying a surcharge anywhere from $1 to wherever they see fit. They make the price. Or, I mean, it could actually be implemented to where the government regulates the price. I don't know. I don't know the reach of this. But essentially, we have been downgraded from like an iPhone X to an iPhone. No, probably worse than that. Probably this. And cell phone carriers did this a couple years ago. You notice when the first iPhone came out, you could get unlimited data. Now, not many carriers offer unlimited data. And just like with AT&T, I have unlimited data on my phone, but in the small print, if I go over 22 gigs a month, they're going to slow down my data. Imagine, and it slowed down to the point to where you can't even hardly use it. If I ever go over my data, I haven't yet, but if I do, well, I did in the past because I had a different plan, they will slow this down to the point to where you can't even receive iMessages. If somebody sends you a picture message, it'll just stay stuck on downloading all day long. It will make your device completely unusable. Now, that's one thing with the cell phone carrier. I don't know how that's going to be impacted by all of this. I'm going to do some research and try to find that out. But imagine having your iPhone connected to your Wi-Fi at home and somebody sending you a picture and it taking an hour to download. An hour. We live in a generation where we came from dial-up internet and was downloading music on Napster that would take hours to where you can download a song in 2 seconds. 2 seconds. Do you want to go back to that? That is not something that I want to ever have a part in again. We want our information and we want it now. And not only is this going to impact the way that we communicate with people around the world, this is going to impact small businesses. This is going to impact YouTubers. This is going to impact anybody that uses an internet connection. Sorry, I'm getting a phone call right now. This is going to impact everybody from the people on eBay to Etsy, from Etsy to Ticketmaster. This is going to impact every single thing that we do in our daily life. You may not use Twitter, but you might use Facebook. You might not use Facebook. You might write a blog. Whatever you do on the internet can and will be slowed down by your internet provider if you do not do whatever you can do right now. Be it writing a congressman, writing a senator, writing your governor, do whatever you can do. I have texted 50409, resist, and done all that. You guys should know how to do that by now. There's a change.org petition. I'm not going to be linking all this stuff right now when I post this video because I don't have time. I'm going to come back later tonight and do that. But you guys, imagine going from the speed of a MacBook to the speed of a Windows XP old Dell. That is not something that you want. If you use the internet for gaming, if you use the internet to watch movies, if you use the internet to watch YouTube, you need to speak out and do whatever you can. because this is going to impact our economy. This is going to impact so many people's jobs. There are going to be jobs lost because of this. If this passes through, we're not all the way there yet. We still have a chance because it still has to go through, like, I think Congress and all that shit. I don't know the specifics. I'm not a Webster. I don't know all that stuff. But we are on the cusp of losing everything, basically, as far as the internet's concerned. The internet enables free speech. The internet is how we all communicate with one another. And basically, what I'm telling you is that if you like social media, if your entertainment is on the internet, you need to do something. Just do whatever you can. I will make a follow-up video to this once I know all the specifics of it. At one point in time, I did know a little bit about it, but it's slipped my mind because I did used to work for an internet provider. But you guys, I'm telling you, this is something that's near and dear to my heart. I'm a 90s child. I do not want to go back to 90 speed internet. I do not want to have AOL dial-up again. I don't. But you guys, I hope you have a great day. I have another video coming shortly. And if this is your first time here, my name is Dustin. And I will see you guys on my next video. Bye.